We know social distancing can work, but how well are we doing it? NBC2 investigator Evan Dean shows us how it's harder than you may realize.
You've heard the term a lot lately, social distancing. Medical experts say you should try to stay about 6 feet apart from one another to slow the spread of coronavirus. But what does that actually look like? We're about to show you. There you have it. That's 6 feet from the center to each corner. And keep in mind, this is a square. If we'd done a circle all the way around, this space would be even bigger yet. All right, so an empty garage is one thing, but what about if you're out in public? This might look a little silly, but for the sake of the story, we've taped two of my hockey sticks together. They're each a little bit longer than 5 feet. So side to side, front to back, it's recommended that you try to stay at least this far away from other people.
For real?
For real?
Yeah.
It's about 5 feet.
Does this seem like a good idea to try to stay away from people?
Oh, absolutely.
But as you can see,
trying to do some social distancing. Sorry, guys. We're working on a news story.
Especially in places like downtown Fort Myers.
How you doing?
Keeping your distance can be difficult.
I don't know how I'm even going to get by you guys.
I mean, you got to have more space than we have. It's not going to work.
We're going to the airport. I know I'm going to be sitting next to somebody I don't know.
We even tried social distancing.
There you go, 6 feet right there. So.
During our interview with FGCU Professor Robert Hawks.
This is not how people normally behave.
Right. This is uncomfortable in carrying on a regular conversation. We'd like to generally be within 3 or 4 feet of people.
But staying further apart right now is important and can flatten the curve, as it's called, lessening the spike in cases and in turn lessening the burden on our healthcare system. And 6 feet is 6 feet for a reason.
We know when people sneeze that the air particles can go 3, 4, 5 feet out. So 6 feet is kind of a good range to decrease the potential spread of the coronavirus.
Hawks admits it's a challenge, especially at places even deemed essential, like grocery stores and gas stations.
Is this even feasible to ask people this?
I think as best as they can, they want to, which is why we're limiting no more than 10 people gathering at a time.
The key here, Hawks says, is at least trying.
I'm already too close to him. If I turn my head this way, I'm already too close to you.
Something people haven't been doing on spring break or during St. Patrick's Day. Remember, doctors say someone without symptoms could have coronavirus and spread it without even knowing it.
What would be your words to somebody who says, I'm not worried about social distancing?
I would not disregard this. I would adhere to the social distancing.
For the NBC2 investigators, I'm Evan Dean.